This is a simple block of embroidery that I have done as a sample. It is about 50 millimeters, and I did this in Wacom, of course saved it as an EMB, and then exported it as a DST. So what I have brought open now is the DST, and notice that there's really nothing here to work with. These are just stitches, 3,900 stitches. If I go to the underlay, everything's grayed out, pull comp. Everything is grayed out. There's really nothing I can do with it. Now, if I open this properly, it gives me more options. So I'll close this down. Oh, first of all, I want to show you this. So with it, the original 50 millimeters, if I change that to 100, my stitch count stays pretty much the same. It's still in the 3,900. And so I would like to add density, as I showed you. There's nothing I could do. So let's go ahead and close it out. And this time we're going to open it with more options. So here's the DST. I'll select it, but I'm not going to go straight to open. Instead, I'm going to go to options. I'll make sure that objects and outlines is checked, and also auto connectors. This is going to convert those single stitches into objects that I can then edit. So we've chosen everything as we want. We'll say OK, and now we will open it. And I have more options to deal with. So when I select it, I'll hit Control A to get everything. I can get into the fields. I can change most anything I want. Control A again to select everything. Let's try our enlarging again. Let's go to 100. I hit Enter. Look how this increased my stitches, almost three times as much. And everything is available to me. Pull comp, underlay, what else might I do? Change my fill, change my stitch type, perhaps a contour. So by changing this to objects, just when you're opening the DST file, you will be able to edit this easily. Thanks for watching.